Welcome back to Phones and Drones. You can see we have had in-house now for a little while the new Samsung Galaxy Z Flip. We've already done our unboxing on this guide. We've done a side-by-side comparison with the original OG Fold. So for those of you that haven't seen it, make sure to check out this channel and go see that today. It's pretty impressive what Samsung has come from and where they have gotten in such a short period of time. Having said all that, if you guys haven't followed along with the channel, haven't seen those other videos, I am definitely impressed by this device so far. Have there been concerns? Yes, but also just how well built this has been in the short time since the original Fold came out is amazing. The first being how much better that hinges. It is so, so smooth. And listen to this. Nothing. No creaking, no anything. So that's a much, much, much better feature right off the bat than that new Motorola Razr that came out. I know this obviously has been getting a lot of comparisons for that and for right reasons, but I do think what Samsung has done here does just blow it out of the water. Does it look a little plain? Would it be nice to have another larger display in here? Of course it was. If you guys haven't seen that, there has been some leaked images of what originally the Z Flip was supposed to look like. It was going to have an actual larger display here, and this whole top would have been an assortment of cameras, more in line with kind of what the original Galaxy had, Fold had. Aside from that, guys, if you haven't paid attention to this, though, this device right here is phenomenal. And right before I was actually about to do this video, I did watch Jerry Rig Everything video in regards to this quote-unquote first glass display, and it raises some questions as to whether this is a plastic glass hybrid, because if you guys haven't seen that, this is not a true glass display, it seems. And in all of Samsung's marketing materials, they're quoting this being a true glass display. Apparently, that's not the case. If you guys have ever used the original Fold, you can feel the plasticky nature on this. That is not how this feels. It's actually pretty interesting. It feels really like true glass, but it doesn't seem to be the case. On this plastic display, you can feel your finger get stuck, but it's a lot smoother on the actual new Z Flip. So I really did think right off the bat that it was true glass. But keep that in mind, the durability might not be there as much as we had hoped. But again, I have had no issues with this at all. One thing that really does show through between these devices is that lack of the high refresh rate. The 90 hertz or 120 hertz that have been really prevalent in the last ending of 2019 and really are going to come to fruition in 2020 with Samsung's own S20 is how fluid those devices feel. This right here is definitely not as smooth. But just keep that in mind. If you're looking for a higher refresh rate, you might want to look elsewhere. One other area that Samsung has improved, and I hope the camera can pick this up for you guys, is these little bumpers on the corner here. They're on both edges, and it's to help when you close the phone so the glass, we'll quote, glass on glass does not touch and crack. But if it's true glass, that would be an issue. Right now, it's really, really questionable at best. But aside from that, you are getting those two cameras on the back, one on the interior display. I have a couple of qualms on this device, and right off the bat is this scratch resistance on the outside display. Or casing, I should say. I've gotten micro scratches already on the back. Let me give it a wipe down. Let's see if you can pick this up on camera. So if I get it in the right light, you can see there is a ton of micro scratches on this device. I have had it for a little over 24 hours, and that is concerning. The other thing is, for those of you who are old enough to know, the original flip phones, you know, you can kind of open and shut pretty simply. This is not really a one-handed phone. You really do need two hands to be able to open it up. Closing it, not so much. Additionally, too, this little 1.1-inch display right here is not that responsive. And it really is useless. For those of you guys that get a lot of notifications a day, having to double tap these and swipe to the right to see what you have outstanding, it gets a little tedious. You're going to end up opening and closing this phone probably more than you should have to. Additionally, too, there is no always-on display feature for the outer display. in the settings for always on display, that actually only takes into account this interior 6.7 inch display. So if you were to leave this open for some reason and set out, that is the only time the always on display will remain active, as you can see. It's a little kind of concerning and questionable at best. I don't know how many people are really just going to be, you know, leaving this phone open on their desk. I guess it's possible, but no one's going to be leaving it open in their pocket like that. It just defeats the purpose of these kind of phones. Really, aside from those are my only two quarrels. The one downward-facing speaker actually sounds pretty good. I've had no issues with that at all. Sound quality is great. Phone quality is great. That little earpiece, it works. Samsung's never had any issues with really phone quality. What else, guys? Any other questions you guys might need, ask me down below. Leave a note in the comments. I'll be happy to walk through that with you. Yes, that fold's still there. I kind of touched on that in the comparison video. It's not as noticeable, but you can definitely see it even just sitting there. That there is definitely a fold in this display. Really, right now, the questions remain with that. Is it glass? How's the durability going to be? The battery life? I just haven't had it long enough to do a full review on that yet. But let me know what you guys think. Do you like one of these two devices over the other one? Which would you prefer form factor wise? Would you take the original OG Galaxy Fold, or do you guys like the new Z Flip? Leave a comment down below, guys, and we'll be sure to go into details with that on the next video. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll catch you in the next one.